So this was studied in 7,000 patients, randomized trial, mean age was 63. Almost 57% patient had long-standing diabetes, more than 10 years. This was, follow-up was for 3.1 year. Two doses were studied, 10 milligram per day and 25 milligram per day. Baseline therapy of metformin, insulin or sulfonylurea were continued in both. Primary endpoint was death from cardiovascular cause, non-fatal MI or non-fatal stroke, and secondary composite outcome was primary outcome plus hospitalization for unstable angina. So what was the outcome? This glycated hemoglobin level was slightly less compared to placebo or standard therapy. Of course, at this difference at the end of trial period was not much. It was just 0.4 only. But in spite of that, for the first time in history, some anti-diabetic drug caused significant reduction in primary endpoint. Death from cardiovascular causes, non-fatal MI and non-fatal stroke was significantly less with empagliflozin. Even death from cardiovascular causes or death from any cause was significantly less with the active drug. And another important point, most of these new molecules causes heart failure, while here hospitalization for heart failure was also significantly less with empagliflozin, and this difference was also significant. So message from this trial was that in patients with type 2 diabetes and high cardiovascular risk, empagliflozin has significantly lower MACE and cause less death from any cause when added to standard care. But it had some side effect, and then FDA gave warning in the last month only that it causes more ketoacidosis and more serious urinary tract infection. So this was introduced, or companies were instructed to include this as a label of warning.